Hey, what's good, everybody? It's CJ Beats. We're back at it again today. Today, I'm going to make a Playboy Cardi Type beat in Logic Pro X. You guys hit me up a lot on this one and wanted to see it. A lot of you also requested a remake. This is actually a remake of the beat, Magnolia. I'm going to let you hear it really quick, and then we're going to get into recreating the whole thing.
Yo, Pierre, you want to come out here?
So we're going to break down each element now. I'm going to quickly show you here the classic 80s synth. So before I manipulated the sound, it sounded like this, and it's just a B minor chord being played over and over and over again. So let's go ahead and solo out the first instrument. This is a classic 80s synth. It's a classic 80s synth, and before I manipulated the sound with a reverb and an EQ, it sounded like this. So this is just a, you know, B minor chord being played over and over again. I'll open up the piano roll to let you see the chord itself. Okay, just repeats like that. And it's B, D, and F sharp. Okay, so the next sound that we have is the 808. And I'll double click this region so you can see the mini notes here as it plays. Hear them together. So I dropped an EQ on the or reverb rather on that 80s classic synth, and then also an EQ, and the EQ chopped some of the lows and some of the highs out. So let's see here, the 808 has initially I put some distortion and all that on there, but then I found a better fitting 808, so I put that in there. So not much I put that, let's see here, I just pitch shifted it by 7 semitones. This is how it sounded before, and then I pitch shifted it. You can find the pitch shifter just in like the effects section, and then go to pitch and pitch shifter like that, and you can change it. Always make sure your mix is at 100%. Sounds weird now because two of them were on there, but always make sure it's on at 100%, so when you're changing the semitones, like the whole sound gets manipulated. If it's only 50%, it's like a combination of the original and the pitched one. So always make sure it's 100. So bring this back down to -7 semitones. Okay, the next thing I created was the clap. Very simple, every half bar or so. One thing that I wanted to discuss was also like the BPM. You could tell it's really slow, it's 81.5. When I was searching for the BPM for the song, if you look on Google, it says 109, so that's incorrect. It has to be 81.5, all right? Of course, you got your hi-hats in there. Hi-hats don't do much, they just, you know, are played at a 1/16th rate all throughout the song. Then the second section here, I added the kick and the flute. So you got the kick that comes in, the flute, so let me unsolo all of this. I'm gonna go ahead and recreate this now. So I'm gonna drag these over here, and might use them for reference or something like that. But let's go ahead and loop off our section that we want to work with here. All right, so we're gonna go here to, let's make that four bars. We'll work on the classic 80 synth. I'm gonna go ahead and draw in a, select my pencil tool and draw in a region like that. Let's make it four bars. If you double click it, the piano roll appears. So I'm gonna do that and work in the piano roll. So like I said, it was just a, B minor chord, very simple. So I'm gonna turn it off first and let you hear it. So when I created it, it sounded like this. Loop it, make it quicker. So I added a reverb on it. It's the silver verb. You could find that under reverb and then silver verb like that. And then I brought the wet mix up to 74 on the default setting. And then after that I use an EQ. You can find the EQ under dynamics, and you can find it under EQ and then channel EQ. I just chopped off some of the low and the high end. All right, let's work on that 808. I'm gonna hit Command on my keyboard and then expand a region like this. Got my pencil tool, right? All right, so let's go ahead and recreate that that 808. Play that in with my keyboard. Let me make sure my click is on. Okay. And the countdown.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
All right, Command A to select them all, Q to quantize. It's 1/16th note. Let's bring all those volumes up. If they're all selected, you can change the volume on all of them at the same time. So some of these were a little bit like shorter. Yeah, just like that. I'm just gonna loop it off too. Let's work on that clap. See what fits. It's always important, like when you're, you know, putting in drums, try to find a similar pitch. All right, real simple.
Yo, Matt Pierre, Nar.
Command R to record.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
Alright. Command A, Q to quantize, bring the volumes up. Let's loop that off. Cool, now I'm gonna build in some hats. So, should be very simple. Let's use the brush tool and Scale it 1/16th, that's good. Copy and paste these over to the next four bars, and let's work on that kick. So I think it goes, what was it, C1? Yeah. Now I have a compressor on this kick here. That's what it sounded like before. With the compressor, this is stock compressor. See how much more that knocks? I'll show you in a second the settings to make it sound like that. Now the original beat, the kick wasn't knocking like this, but I thought it really emphasized it. All right, so let's work on that kick, and I'm just gonna loop off this four bar section now. That. Now with the compressor, you can find the compressor under dynamics and then compressor. Looks like this. You want to select drums and then type U tight kit. And then you can mess with the makeup. I have it at 11 decibels. You can mess with the makeup to make it like, you know, less knockier, but I like the way it sounds at 11. All right, next let's work on that flute and E, E, D, C sharp, A. Open up the piano roll so you can see. Let's find the key really quick here. There it is. You can see it on the side here. So I'm going to go ahead and play that in with the keyboard. All right. Command A, Q to quantize. You can leave, the way it came out like this. Maybe bring this one up like this in terms of the volume, because you want to give it somewhat of a natural feel, I guess, for the flute. Add an EQ again. You could add the EQ like this. Go to EQ and then go to channel EQ. Took out the low end and took out the high end. Create space for the artist, you know. Beat itself, you have a little pause too that happens. Like, let me see where that was. All right, so right around here, that Pierre sample comes back in. So you can you could select these like so. So I'm going to use the scissor tool, and then I'm going to cut a section out like so. I'm gonna hit keep. Now you can simply select that section, delete it. Hit delete on the keyboard to delete it. All right, and bring that sample over like this. Alright, so I'm going to copy these ones twice more over like that. And here we go. This is it.
Yo, Pierre, you want to come out here?
Now you could take this whole section like this. Paste it over a couple times.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I definitely enjoyed making it. If you have any questions, you know what to do. Put those in the comment section. My name's CJ Beats, and I'm out for now.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?